Have you ever been in a GPS fight with someone in the car? We need to listen to the GPS. No, we don't. I know where we're going. Just look at the signs. I love my GPS, sometimes to a fault. And now scientists know exactly what's going on inside our brains when we rely on our navigation apps to guide us from point A to point B. We go on autopilot. In the UK, volunteers underwent a series of simulated tests while fMRIs captured their brain activity. Participants were shown movies of where they were, given a goal of where to go, and then told to either make a left or a right to reach their end destination. When the volunteers were navigating on their own, without GPS, researchers noted spikes of activity in the hippocampus, which is involved in memory and spatial navigation, and in the prefrontal cortex, a key area for planning and decision-making. But then when the participants were using GPS, the hippocampus and prefrontal cortex went completely inactive. This told the researchers that when GPS does the thinking and the planning for you, your brain basically checks out. Using the hippocampus is super important because we suspect it stores mental maps, sort of like our brain's very own GPS. It helps us remember where we've been and where we're going in three-dimensional space. The hippocampus helps us picture what's in front of us, and the prefrontal cortex helps us decide which way we should turn. These findings corroborate another study which found that when we rely on GPS, we stare at our screens way more and we disengage from the outside world. Do you even remember what it was like to drive before GPS? We had to work hard to pay attention to our surroundings. We had to assemble pictures in our heads, remember landmarks, roads, intersections, and improvise quicker routes all on our own. We had to actually use a map made of paper. And that requires a whole other set of skills. But when we rely on GPS, we're focusing more on the blue lines and dots on a screen than on the journey itself. Visualizing our environment through spatial orientation is a natural ability we all have, but it's a use it or lose it type of skill. And it's relevant not just for driving. We use spatial orientation in our daily jobs, our home life, and in all sorts of other tasks. Plus, flexing our hippocampi can keep our brains alert and active. And keeping your brain active can help protect it from future cognitive impairment due to afflictions like Alzheimer's disease. So think about it. If your GPS told you to drive straight into the Pacific Ocean, would you do it? That's exactly what happened to tourists who found themselves ankle deep in ocean water after being misled by their GPS device. This just shows how much we switch into autopilot. There have been plenty of anecdotal hints that our mechanical co-pilots encourage us to just chuck common sense out the window. There are cases of people being lured into lakes, off bridges, down hiking trails, and even into the desert by that soothing robotic voice. Mine's got an Australian accent. There's even a phenomenon called death by GPS. Literally, people following their GPS into peril. Sure, satellite navigation is incredibly convenient and comforting. It takes the guesswork out of navigation. But don't let a little fear of the unknown deter you from strengthening your prefrontal cortex and your hippocampus. It might be a good idea to get lost on your own for a change. I don't think I'm gonna stop listening to my Australian co-pilot anytime soon. What about dogs and cats and birds? How do they find their way around town without their own GPS? Julia knows the way, you can watch it here. And what about you? Are you gonna stop using GPS and give your brain a workout? Tell us down in the comment section and please subscribe for more videos.